So the thing I want to say is that every story you've heard about crowdfunding in the news is wrong. This is every story you've ever heard. Some guy puts a project up on Kickstarter, and 2 days later, the money truck backs up to his house with $1 billion inside. It just like money falls from the sky. That's every story you ever hear about crowdfunding. And you know what? It's not like that at all in any way. What our data shows and what the data from everyone else shows is it all based upon your audience. You know, how big is your audience and how passionate is that audience?
Hey, it's Crystal with the AudioPHiD, and I'm hanging out with Dr. Jai Ranganathan. He's a marine biologist and co-founder of...
Terrestrial biologist. Let me tell you, terrestrial and marine biologist, we get it on.
Okay.
We fight, so it's very important.
Terrestrial biologist.
Yes.
And a co-founder of the SciFund Challenge.
That's right.
Tell me about that and how that came about.
It had nothing to do with cash, you know, because I'm a conservation biologist. And I got into this business because I'm really interested in having a conservation impact on the planet. You know, as industriously as a grad student, as a postdoc, getting those papers out and saying, aha, all we need to do is to get the papers out. And then the world is, by some mysterious process that I don't quite understand, it's going to change. And you know, I got some papers out, and some of them even got some good media attention. But then the world didn't change. There's such a giant gap between science and society. I mean, think of our lives today versus our great-grandparents' lives 100 years ago. I mean, there's so much change. It's all because of science and technology. And most of us have no connection to it. It might as well be black magic.
Right.
And why is this? Why is there such a giant gap between science and society? A big part of it is because of the scientists. Scientists don't reach out. They don't talk to the general public. The ivory tower.
Yeah, they stay in their tower,
yeah,
in their offices.
It's a real thing, yeah? People may not know, but we're seeing more change in science now than we've seen in the past 70 to 80 years, maybe the past 300 years. And science outreach, science crowdfunding is a small piece of a much bigger puzzle. It's like seeing, you know, your leg of the elephant.
Do you know, are you ready?
Yeah. All right.
Woo! Good thing I'm tall. Tell me about SciFund, the way that you would want to describe it. What is it and how does it work?
This is not a money-making venture for us. The purpose isn't that. We train scientists how to do outreach. In fact, that's the point of what we do. All scientists who are part of the SciFund Challenge round, we spend a month training them how to do outreach and have them not just us telling them, but having them help each other. You know, for most scientists, they've never done outreach. They've never put a video together. I mean, all the things you need to do for a crowdfunding campaign, you need to do for outreach, period. Everyone's helping each other with actually, everyone's obviously promoting their own projects, mm-hmm. but they're really helping to promote each other as well. And so that's how SciFund Challenge works. But the real point of it, the real power of it, is a community of people who believe in outreach. I feel like we might have to swim home. I mean, this is, you know, like.
What's the next step? What's next for the funding model and how we do research and how we approach all of that?
I think there's a complicated answer, but I think the way science is done and the way it's funded, it will change. This era of unlimited funding, I mean, that's over. Funding for science is getting cut. I mean, it's getting stretched. This is the future we're in. So scientists, if they expect to get any funding from the government and ultimately from the taxpayer, they have to make the case why their science matters and why people should care about
it. So effective communication is getting more and more important for the survival of your research and your field.
And even particularly from a pure crowdfunding perspective, I mean, our data clearly shows the bigger your audience, the more you're likely to raise. Generally speaking, the amounts of money that are being raised through science crowdfunding is relatively low. We're talking low to mid thousands. That's not because people aren't interested in science or because it can't be as big. It's because scientists are just getting started with building their audiences. As the audience size grows, we can also expect the amount of money to be raised also to increase as well. I think the key idea here is like to connect people to the wonder of what they're doing. Many things, there's not something so practical that in the next 5 years you'll have the better watch or the faster computer. But it's more that, hey, this is really cool. It's really beautiful. I think for most biologists, you know, they study it because they find it beautiful. And just connecting to that sense of wonder, that's all you need. My name is Jai Ranganathan, and you're listening to my dulcet voice on the AudioPHiD.